All right, the finals, mono green, can we do it? Yes, we probably can. We'll keep. It's a good start. What are we up against? Red, white here? Crunch. Maximum damage. Evolutionary Leap's kind of a cool draw here, because if my opponent stabilizes, looks like they might not be, though. Then I can get a bunch of value from Leap, but it's not the kind of card I want to play in the early part of the game here. I just want to keep adding power to the board whenever I can. And I mean, I missed there. Elvish Visionary was not a great turn for us, but I guess it was better than our opponent, who's apparently discarding. Oh my god, what the heck? How did this deck make it to the finals? Let's see if we can't hit again. I should have actually just waited on that. That was a little greedy. So I attack with all these, and if he uses a burn spell, I really get him with Titanic Growth. But if I play this first and miss, then they can actually get a burn spell off, which is just, like, you know, kind of lame for us. I mean, obviously, maybe it's not obvious. It should be that, you know, we're so far ahead that the thing that we should be thinking about here is, how do we lose this game, right? Like, what are the sequence of draws and circumstances that happen that have us actually lose this game? That's the question. 2, 4, 5, 6. So yeah, I think we can't lose from that position. Anyway, so yeah, I should have just attacked first and then played it, but not a huge deal. Opponent's playing blue red with Angel's Tomb and Skob Goliath. What in the world are we even looking at here? Whatever, I don't know. I'm just going to run it back and see what happens. I'm just trying to get my head around the combination of Angel's Tomb and Skobgul. I just cannot fathom how those two cards could be in the same deck on multiple levels. Like Angel's Tomb's not even good. And when it is good, it's because you can curve out. And it's not a creature. So it doesn't actually help with the Goliath either. It's just very weird. I kept this hand. I don't know. I think it's just okay. Ow. It's making a little more sense now. This is the second time this draft that we've bottom two lands and hit a creature. I'm not shocked. I mean, we're playing a bunch of creatures, but still, it's pretty sweet when it actually happens. Let's see if this actually resolves. Our opponent did nothing. All right, I guess it does. Get this token out of the sky, get a little value from our naturalist, and make a 4-4. Not bad turn. Claustrophobia. All right. Can I have my naturalist back, please? All right, well, we're hitting land, so we can hold off on Nissa here. Yeah, that's fine, actually. I'm just going to go Yavis Force Mage, Timberpack Wolf, I think. I just want to go wide, obviously. The Draga Invocation is sort of driving the way this game is going to play out for us. Could just play Nissa here. Does leave her vulnerable. I'm just going to wait. It's fine. It's not the maximum mana efficiency, but it's not bad. Lightning Javelin. All right, well, he's trying to one-for-one us out, which is, you know, it's not bad for our opponent. Oh, that's a good draw. I'm just going to play that. I just decided to play this because it works well with Invocation and because it's a must-deal-with threat, so if he has removal, he's going to have to use it immediately. Oh, God, this could work out great for us. Oh, those have haste? They can't attack, though, right? Maybe one of them? No, none of them. So I could just go for Invocation here and basically wipe my opponent's board. I could also wait a turn and do it. I think I just go now, though. Coast is relatively clear. Now, my opponent could save these Thopters by activating Whirler Rogue here, but they might need them to survive. Yeah. All right. Well, now you get to keep Whirler Rogue. And we're going to bring you down to a low life total and get a massive guy. And next turn we go Nissa Vastwood Seer, land, play it, flip, and then also play Empath. It's pretty sick. Might just make a 4-4 here. Yeah, I think I just make a 4-4 here. Okay, so now we've got a superiorly lethal ground game here. If we get like Chandra's Ignitioned, we still have Rock Maulers, and we have these guys back. Normally, I wouldn't play the Llanowar Empath on the last turn just because of that. Oh, he says Island. Oh, yeah, that sucks. Looks like our opponent has flooded out a bit on us. Had some issues there for sure. Though it does kind of interestingly highlight, you know, the issue of mana, right? Like, we could have played blue, but we decided instead to play mono green. Why do we do that? Well, because it has better mana. And our opponent's clearly ran bad. I mean, that, you know, you flood out that hard, there's not much you can do. But it is interesting to consider. Anyway, that's going to do it for the draft. We took it down with mono green. They say it's the worst color, but I guess when you get all the green cards, it's not too bad. If you want to find me on social media, I'm Marshall_LR, and you can find episodes every week of Limited Resources Podcast here on channelfireball.com or at lrcast.com. We'll see you guys next time. We'll be right back.